Now I show you top-down parsing formalized for parsing as deduction. Here we have our axiom, which initially fills the table. And as you might remember, in top-down parsing, we start with our start symbol on the stack. And then we could write down our rest input onto the into the item as well, but here we just have an index or a counter that tells us how much of the input string we have already seen. At the beginning we haven't seen anything of it, so we just start with a zero. Then we have the scan rule, and here you see again our great love for Greek symbols. So the alpha here, it means it can be an arbitrary string consisting of terminals and non-terminals from our grammar. For the scan rule, at the beginning we need to have a terminal symbol, and this terminal must be the same as the next input symbol of the next terminal symbol in our input string. So W is the word or the input string that we want to pass. So in this example it would be AABB. And if this holds, that the next symbol, that the first symbol on our stack is a terminal, which is the next symbol of our input string, then we can remove the terminal symbol from the stack and we can increase the counter by 1. Then we have here our predict rule. If we have a non-terminal symbol at the beginning of the stack, and the non-terminal symbol, so this is a side condition, if the non-terminal symbol is the left-hand side of a production rule of our grammar, then we can, the right-hand side is now here symbolized by gamma, so it can be an. Again, it can be an arbitrary combination of terminals and non-terminals. So what we are exchanging the non-terminal on the stack by whatever the right-hand side is to derive our new item. And then we want to have a goal item, which our goal item is when our stack is empty and the count, and we need to have seen the whole input string. So n must be now the same, well, this is written down a little bit complicated. So W is our input string and the two bars are telling us that we want to have the length of the input string, so the amount of terminal symbols in it, and this will be our n. So in our goal item, our stack shall be empty. And the number, the index, the counter must be the same as the length of our input string. Now I show you the top-down parsing formalized as parsing for deduction with the same example as before. So again, we now here have our table, which might look a little bit different. Here we have again our line number. We have the item, which is written down here. We have the rule that tells us how a line was derived. And here we have the back pointers that tell us which previous lines were used to derive the new lines. So, this might look oddly similar to the top-down parsing I showed you in the previous video, because it was already very much like a table, but they are also parsing algorithms which work on two-dimensional tables, so they're the formalization to the abstraction to parsing as deduction is a little bit, is not so straightforward as for top-down parsing. And also here we have our agenda, which now consists of the same item as our table, and in the first step we will remove this item from the agenda and use it to derive new items. So, here we have the non-terminal at the beginning of the stack with nothing following it. So, but we can apply again the predict rule. So, the parser does not know really which rule to use and tries out everything. So, here we are getting our two new items, which were also put into the agenda. The rule applied was the predict rule, once with this production rule and once with this. And as small implementation detail, the terminals and non-terminals might be longer than one symbol, so to make it obvious what one symbol is, there are spaces between the tokens. But other than that, it is the same as before. So, and here the back pointer says we applied this onto the first line. Here we exchanged the S by this right hand side, so ASB, and we are left with ASB and the item. And the second possibility with S derives to AB, there we exchange the S by AB, and now we have those items. Then we have those two items. In the next step, we are using this item and trying out different rules, and the only thing we can do now on line 2 is to perform the scan step. So we are having the A at the beginning of the stack, and as you might remember, our input string we want to pass is AABB. So the first symbol on the stack is the same as the first symbol on from our input string, so we can remove the A from the stack and increase the counter by 1. So then the next item from the agenda we can use. So in this case we are using the item that is first on the agenda, so it's the oldest item. And the next item we use is now AB, and the only thing we can do with it is a scan step. There you have it. On line 3 we performed a scan step, removing the A, so we are left with a single B, and you might see it, this will not lead to a successful parsing, because we would need a lot more symbols. We would need 4 symbols, but we have only 1 symbol left here. So then our next item has a non-terminal symbol at the beginning. So we are adding 2 more items, which we got by applying the predict rule. Again, the parser tries out all possibilities that there are. Then the next item we have on the agenda is with the B at the beginning. And we have only seen the first A, so we cannot even apply a scan step to that, because the next symbol we would need to see would be an A, but we have a B, so we just remove this item without doing anything. But then with the next item, which was line 6, we can again perform the scan step. Down here, we remove the A from the stack because it's the same input symbol as the next symbol on our input string. Then our next item, this is the one that will lead to our successful trace. So on line 7, we are performing another scan. And as you might remember, now in line 9 we have seen our 2 A's and we are left with the 2 B's we still need. So the line 9 will lead to our successful trace. But on our agenda, the next item has a non-terminal at the beginning, so We will perform predict steps once again and adding those items which are well useless from now on. But from now, the item from line 9 is the next one on our agenda, so we can perform another scan step on line 9. Leaving us with a single B, and we have already seen 3 symbols from our input string. And then in the last step, we are consuming the last B, and as you might remember, this one is our goal item. The input stack, the stack is empty, and we have seen everything from our input string. So this is our goal item. That means the parsing was successful and the string is part of our language and can be derived from our grammar.